Why do you want women to be poor forever?
What? When did I say that I wanted women to be poor forever?
Because if you and your Christianness make me have my baby and I'm poor, then I'm going to be poor forever.
Okay.
So I have to get an abortion because I don't want to be poor.
Okay.
And not be able to feed a child.
Okay.
So I need an abortion.
Okay.
So what do you say to that?
All right. One, I think it's a big deal because I think there's a lot of abortions that happen because of this reasoning.
Okay.
All right. So
is this the most common reason?
Is it the most common? I think probably the top two is economic situations and pressure from partner or from parents.
Okay. We're getting to that one.
Okay. So I think it's probably the top two.
Okay.
I think that's, there are so many resources now for individuals. So like, in other words, if they're concerned about how do I make it through the pregnancy, pay for the pregnancy, all that kind of stuff, there are so many resources now with, pregnancy support centers, and organizations such as Love Life, which is a national organization that actually help provide and the care and the financial support for people who may find themselves in need of financial support through the pregnancy. And so if that's the issue, I would plead for people to don't have an abortion on that basis, because there can be the financial provision. If you feel like you can, you know, if you feel like it's the after the child's being born, that's the economic issue.
Right.
You know, okay. So two things. One, adoption. And I will say it to the cows come home, is such an incredible gift you can give to that child and to another family.
So you don't have a problem with anybody giving their babies up for adoption?
Probably anybody giving their babies up for adoption. And I think adoption is completely, it's a great option.
Option compared to anything else?
Definitely compared to abortion.
Okay.
Obviously, I think that, and this happens some too, where you have an individual, they believe they do want to put the child up for adoption, will go through that process, and then will choose to back out of that process. Because they realize they do want that child after all. And most state laws are in place to where you have like 30 days after the child is born to make the final decision.
Okay.
Some of them it's 2 weeks. I think there's one state that's really long, like maybe even like a year, which I think is way too long. Yeah. I think that's not healthy for that child or for the parents that received that child. I think that's not healthy for probably any of the parties involved. But, you know, for a 30-day window or 2-week window, I think that's very reasonable. So I think adoption's a great option for parents or for a woman that feels like I can't raise this child. My options are abortion or adoption. Choose adoption. Every time, choose adoption.
Okay. You said it right that time.
Yeah, good. Thank God. And so I think there's so many, and I mean, and there's more pregnancy centers than there are Planned Parenthood centers.
Really?
Yeah.
I thought Planned Parenthoods were like everywhere.
Nah. They kind of portray themselves as that, but they're not. And there's so many pregnancy support centers and services in almost every small town you go to.
Okay.
I mean, I say small town. I mean, you know, in a lot of towns, there's those pregnancy support groups, support centers, and so which help women in this very situation navigate these things. So I don't think the economic part has to be a reason for abortion, and I definitely think there's a lot of other options out there to help individuals get through that. And then, of course, you know, I will say for us as a church, and I can only speak for our church family, for us as a church, if we had someone and we knew that it was going to be financially difficult, we would want to come up alongside that individual and help them financially through that process and through that journey, you know, for the sake of them and for that child. So we would, you know, even if they're married and that kind of, like, we would, we want to come up alongside you and help you. So